Tuesday the 12th of September, and the Reverends Jason and Alan send their love and blessings to everyone. Our opening prayer for today. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace come, we ask that you stir in our hearts the true love of peace, and that you guide the leaders of the nations with your peaceable wisdom until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Amen. Our readings today are Psalm 8 and Zechariah chapter 6, verses 9 to 15. Yesterday we heard that the laying of the temple foundation stone is in itself a small act, but it signifies so much more. Now, I speak from experience relating to the laying of foundation stones, because, of course, St. Luke's Hall was a new building project. The groundwork linked to the foundations proved to be a much more major task than anticipated. So everyone wanted to see the laying of the first brick above ground. That, for us, symbolised that the project really was moving on, and it was a great encouragement for all involved. Zerubbabel has laid the foundation stone as an act of faith based on God's promises. So, how are those promises now going to be fulfilled? It seems that the name Zerubbabel means scattered in Babylon. Now, the scattered Israelites are being gathered back together. They are told to make a collection to help to pay for this temple rebuild. And it seems that some of the exiles did rather well for themselves in Babylon, and they are quite wealthy, including only precious items such as gold. The gold is to be reformed into crowns, one of which is specifically for Joshua, the high priest. Now, we heard about Joshua a couple of days ago because he was the one in the image of the dirty clothing. The crown which he is to receive is to signify that God is in control and is guiding both the spiritual and secular lives of everyone, because God is in control of everything. And that, of course, includes the temple rebuild. We come to our next prayer. Sovereign God, the defence of all who put their trust in you, and the strength of all who suffer, look in mercy on all who are afflicted and oppressed, and deliver them through the might of our Saviour Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. For our prayer points today, we start by praying for all leaders. Then let's pray for the running of local government. And then pray for those who have influence in our local communities. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I don't know about you, but for the first time for a good while, I'm wondering about taking an umbrella out with me today. Hopefully, if I do, it's not needed. Jesus, the King, the Eternal,